So here we are going to discuss about barrel shifters and MAC units. So coming to the shifter, shifters are basically used to either scale down or scale up the operands or the results. Okay, so that is what we consider. If I consider it as a shifter. Now the following scenarios give the necessity of a shifter, like why we require exactly a shifter. Okay, so if I go with the necessity or requirement of a shifter, for example, while performing addition of n numbers and the size of these numbers are n bits long, then the sum can grow up to n plus log n to the base 2. It means that if I consider the addition of n numbers and the size of each number is n bits wide, then the sum what I get on adding these numbers results in a length of n plus log n to the base 2. Okay, so if I go with this concept, I require the need of a shifter, because whatever I consider the length, it will be more as there is increase in the value of n and the length of those n bits. So if the accumulator is of n bits long, then obviously the overflow will occur. So you know that the accumulator size is limited or restricted to some bits long. So if the result is exceeding the size of the accumulator, then obviously there is an overflow. So this can be improved or this can be overcome by using a shifter, either by scaling the operand down by an amount of log n to the base 2 for this particular example. So I want to just restrict it to a value which is fitted into the accumulator as a result. So that is, it is scaled down by some value which is log n to the base 2. Similarly, while calculating the product of two numbers, if I multiply two numbers instead of performing any other operation, the product can go up to 2 n bits long. You know that if I have two 8-bit numbers, the product will go up to 2 into 8 bits long. So that is 16-bit wide. So in such case, we require the shifter. Then, generally or normally what we consider, the lower n bits get neglected. I already told you regarding this, there is a discarding of bits. Okay, whenever multiplication is done, there is a conventional process which is adopted with which the lower bits are neglected or discarded, and the sign bit is shifted to save the sign of the bit, sign of the product. So sign bit is normally the MSB of any result what we obtain. So that is considered to be the requirement of a shifter. Finally, in case of addition of two floating point numbers, so earlier we have just taken up a concept of fixed point numbers. If I go with the floating point number, one of the operand has to be shifted to make the exponents of the two number equal. So if I consider two floating point numbers, and in this floating point numbers, one of the operand has to be shifted. One of the operand has to be shifted so that it can make the exponents of two numbers equal. Unless the exponents of two numbers are equal, then there is a problem with adding those two numbers. So from these three cases, what we can say that a shifter is required for the DSP implementation. So that we require a shifter. Here what we consider a type of shifter is a barrel shifter. Okay, so considering one example, it is required to find the sum of 64. So capital N is 64, 16 bit number. So this is the size of the number. So it is 16 bit wide. How many bits should the accumulator have so that the sum can be computed without the occurrence of overflow error or loss of accuracy? See, there is a size of the accumulator which is given around 16 bits, 32 bits, 24 bits, so on. If the size of the result is exceeding the size of the accumulator, then the result won't be fitted into the accumulator. So whatever sum we are going to calculate, that should be without any overflow, without the occurrence of overflow, or there should not be any loss of accuracy. So in that case, I go with the solution of that. The sum of 64 16-bit numbers can grow up to n plus log n to the base 2. We have seen that already. This is capital N, this is small n. So we go with the So this is a small n, and this is capital N. So here we have taken the sum of 64 16-bit number. So size of the number is taken as small n, and the sum of the numbers are taken as capital N. So small n plus log n to the base 2. So the length will be 22 bits. So the accumulator size should be 22 bits. Means it can hold this 22 bit as a result. So 22 bit number as a result will be stored in the accumulator. So to avoid overflow error, we can see that the accumulator size should be 22. If it is more than that, that's not a problem. If it is 24 bits or 32 bits, that doesn't create any problem. If it is not 22 bits, for example, if it is 16 bit, then the accumulator will not hold that particular data. Then the lower bit should be discarded in such cases. If such thing happens, then accuracy will be not in the case of implementation. There will be no accurate value, or there will be no accuracy. Then there might be overflow if the result is considered to be 22 bits only for a 16-bit accumulator size. So problem 2. In the problem, it is decided to have an accumulator with only 16 bits. Okay, so in such cases, see, just now I told you about 16-bit accumulator, which is getting a result of 22 bits. Then there should be a 6 bits prior to addition operation in order to avoid the condition of overflow. It means the accumulator size is lesser than 6 bits. So that should be shifted by an amount of log 64 to the base 2, which is giving us 6 bits. So initially the shift operation has to be done, then the process of addition or multiplication has to be done. Here in this case, the process of addition has to be done. Then third one, if all the numbers in the problem are fixed point integers, what will be the actual sum of the numbers? Okay, so we have a small formula. Actual sum is actual content into 2 power 6. So we have seen that there is a shift of 6 bits towards left side after the sum being computed. So that is in case of the previous problem where we have considered 6 bits which are to be shifted. So based on that, I can say that accumulator sum is equal to, actual sum is equal to accumulator content into 2 power the shifted number of bits, which is 6. Then comes the barrel shifter. So this is the shifter what we are going to use. So in conventional microprocessor, normal shift registers are used for shift operations. Whereas in DSP, we cannot use just a shifter for performing shifting operation, but we are going with barrel shifter. So what is this barrel shifter? As it requires one clock cycle for each shift, it is not desirable for DSP application, which generally involves more shifts. Okay, because for each shift which has to be considered in a microprocessor, we require one clock cycle. But if I go on using the same concept by using just a conventional method of shifting a data or shifting a sample in a DSP processor, then we end up with n number of clock cycles which are required for n number of shifts. So that will be a problem for any DSP application. So in other words, for DSP application, the speed is a very critical issue, as well as the accuracy is very important one. So several shifts are being accomplished in a single execution cycle. So that is what we require, because the DSP implementation is mainly based on the speed, because we require the operation to be done very fast. Then this can be accomplished by using a barrel shifter. So it has got a simple architecture or a structure. So this is a shifter, and we can see that there is an input, a data is fed to a shifter, and it is producing the output, which is the output depending on these two input lines. One is called as a control input, one is the number of bit positions for the shift. So how many bit positions you are going to shift, so that will be enabled using this particular line. And L/R bar gives you the type of shift which has to be carried out. So that is control input. Control input in the sense, either the data has to be shifted towards left or the data has to be shifted towards right. So that is what we consider in this barrel shift. So we can see that with a small example here. Input, we have 4 bits, A3, A2, A1 and A0. And if I go with S0, that is a switch used here. Here. So S0. So if S0 is connected, or it means that is enabled, then I can see that there is no change in the output data, A3, A2, A1 and A0. So whatever input we consider, that will be entirely transferred to the output. So that B3, B2, B1 and B0 will be A3, A2, A1 and A0. Similarly, if I go with the second one, that is A3, A2, A1, A0 is the input and the shift is 1, S1 is 1. So if S1 is considered to be 1, then we can see that A3, A3, then A2 and A1. So A3 is shifted. So here to A2 and A2 is shifted to A1. A1 is shifted to A0 position. Whereas A0 is not shifted to A3. Instead, A3 is again shifted to the A3 position. So similarly, we are going to see for S2 and S3. So this is the implementation of 4-bit right barrel shifter. So if I go with the left barrel shifter, we are going to get here A3, A2, A1, A0, then A3, A2, A1 and A1. So A0 will be discarded. So similarly, we are going to go with left shifter. So we can see that shift to right by 0, 1, 2, 3 are positions can be controlled by setting the control inputs. I already told you regarding that. Either left shift or right shift and the number of shifts which are required. Like one bit shift required or 2-bit or 4-bit or 8-bit shifts which are required. So a barrel shifter is to be designed with 16 inputs for left shifts from 0 to 15 bits. How many control lines are required? So normally if it is 16 bit, it is 2 power n control line, which is log n to the base 2, which is 4 control inputs are required. So this is normally what we consider depending on the number of bits. If it is 8, it is 3 control inputs. If it is 16, it is 4 control inputs. Then we go with the MAC unit, that is multiply unit, multiply and accumulate unit. Already I told you regarding this. It is going to perform multiplication as well as accumulation of data. So most of the applications in DSP require the computation of sum and the products for a series of successive multiplication, because we have a summation which is to be done in the DSP applications. So in order to implement such function, we require a special unit that is called as a MAC unit. So what does this MAC consist of? The MAC consists of a multiplier and a special register. And this special register is nothing but the accumulator. So MACs are used to implement the functions of the type A plus BC. So this is what we require. A plus BC is nothing but BC is a product which is done by using a multiplier, which is performed by a multiplier, which is BC. And plus A, BC plus A, this plus is nothing but addition. So this is done by a register, which is an adder, and the result is stored in the accumulator. So that is a typical MAC unit we can observe here. So this is the MAC unit. So this is the input and this is the other input Y, and the signal is multiplied and it is stored in the product register, giving us 2n. And the accumulator is going to send the 2-bit wide data, which is 2n, to the adder, or it may also perform subtraction depending on the complemented data. If it is 2 complement data, it is going to perform subtraction. Now here you can see that this is the addition which is performing, this is the multiplication which is performing. So both the operations are done and the result is stored in the accumulator. So here whatever I say, this is performing x into y, and this is performing say z. So this is z plus xy. So I am going to perform multiplication as well as accumulation of the data. So this is what is performed here. So the similar block diagram can also be represented in this way as well. Then the same thing during the multiplication process, accumulator can accumulate the product of previous multiplication. If n products are to be accumulated, n minus 1 multiplications can overlap with n minus 1 addition. So we can see that with one example by considering capital N as 8 bits or 16 or 8 bit number or 16 numbers, 64, 32 bit numbers, etc. So we can use that and we can see what is the multiplication value we require, what is the addition we can consider, and both can overlap. So that is what we consider under the MAC unit. So during the very first multiplication, accumulator will be idle, and during the last multiplication, multiplier will be idle. Either multiplication unit will be idle, which is a multiplier, or accumulator will be idle, so that only one unit is going to be idle at a time. It means the other unit is performing some task. If multiplication is carried out during a process, accumulation is stopped. If accumulation is carrying out in the process, multiplication is stopped. So that n plus 1 clock cycles are required to compute the sum of n products. So this is in general n plus 1 clock cycles for n product terms. So taking up an example, if a sum of 256 products is to be computed using a pipelined MAC unit, and if the MAC execution time of the unit is 100 nanosecond, what will be the total time required to complete the operation? So n is 256, so that is 256 products are to be calculated or computed here. MAC unit requires 257 execution cycles. We have seen that in the previous example concept, 2n plus 1 execution cycles are required. As a single MAC execution time is 100 nanoseconds, so this is single MAC execution time is given as 100 nanoseconds. So for 257 execution cycle, it is multiplied by 257. Then coming to overflow and underflow, while designing a MAC unit, we should see that there is a problem which do not exist for overflow and underflow condition. Like overflow or underflow can be avoided by using some of the concept, like using shifters in the input and the output of a MAC. So that is very much required whenever we go with the underflow and overflow process. Overflow is nothing but whenever the size of the accumulator is lesser than the size of the result what we get. Underflow is that if we get a negative value which cannot be fitted into the accumulator considering the 2's complement form. So providing guard bits in the accumulator, so we can provide guard bits or additional bits in the accumulator which can reduce or which can overcome this overflow and underflow condition. The third one is using saturation logic. So this is the third one what we use. Shifters, we already seen that shifter can be used to reduce the problem which we consider as a process of normalization which is observed in this. Shifters can be provided at the input of the MAC to normalize the data and at the output to denormalize the same. So shifters are normally used to normalize a particular data at the input and they are going to denormalize at the output. Guard bits. Whenever I say that the number of bits which are in the results are exceeding the number of bits which are being stored in the accumulator, that is the size of the accumulator is less, or the size of the accumulator is size of the accumulator cannot hold the result, then we go with the introduction of guard bits. So as a normalization process does not yield an accurate result, it is not desirable for some application. As I told you earlier, the DSP application requires accurate data, so that we are going to use for some applications. So in such cases, we are going to have an alternative, that is usage of additional bits which are called as a guard bits. So we are going to introduce guard bits in the accumulator, so there should not be any overflow error. So add or subtract unit also be modified to manage the additional bits to the accumulator. So either we are going to add some of the bits which are considered to be the additional bits to the accumulator, or they are also termed as the guard bits which can be added to the accumulator. So if I consider a MAC unit whose inputs are 16 bit numbers, if 256 number products can be summed up in this MAC, how many guard bits should be provided for the accumulator to prevent overflow condition from occurring? So we have seen that this is 256 and 16 bit numbers. So we have 256 numbers and the size of each number is 16 bit wide. The sum can be 16 plus log n to the base 2, which is giving us 24 bits. But the size of the accumulator, what we consider here is say 32 bits. So the guard band required is 24 minus 16, which is 8 bits. So if I say 24 bits is the size of the accumulator and the resulting bit which can be stored in the form of a answer or a result in the accumulator is 32 bits, then there is a difference of 8 bits in the accumulator size. So we are going to add additional bits as guard bits into the accumulator so that we can enhance the size of the accumulator to 32 bits. So we can see that this is the block what we can use. Similarly, what should be the minimum width of the accumulator in a DSP device that receives 10-bit A-to-A samples and is required to add 64 of them without causing an overflow. The same concept what we are using, wherein we are getting 16 bits, and this is again the accumulator should be capable of handling these 16 bits, thus requiring 16 minus 10, which is 6 bits.